So I'm going to talk about hyperbaric oxygen therapy in horses. What is hyperbaric oxygen therapy? It was originally developed to treat decompression sickness in scuba divers. It is currently cleared to treat 14 different conditions in humans. The equine patient is placed in a large metal chamber that is pressurized 2 to 3 times normal atmospheric pressure, and the air is replaced with high concentrations of pure oxygen. There are actually only 3 published studies on its effects in horses, which I found kind of surprising because I know they've been using it, but there's not a lot of information out there about it. But 2 of these studies concluded that it is not necessarily recommended as a treatment for any particular case. But despite this, many equine practitioners still recommend it for virtually all equine ailments. How it works, elevated pressure and oxygen concentration combine to force more oxygen into the patient's bloodstream with each breath. This increases the amount of oxygen dissolved in the blood and makes it more available to the injured tissues, which then stimulates growth of new blood vessels in bone or soft tissue, allowing for more oxygen-rich, enriched blood to reach the affected area after treatment. Swelling and inflammation are decreased, allowing blood and therefore oxygen to flow more freely from the area. And high oxygen levels increase the ability of white blood cells to kill bacteria in infected tissues. Anaerobic bacteria are killed directly by a high level of oxygen reaching infected tissues, even if normal circulation has been affected. For the treatment sessions, it generally begins with a 15 to 20 minute period during which the pressure is raised from 1 atmosphere to 2.5. The chamber operator maintains the unit at the elevated pressure for around an hour. At the end of 1 hour, the chamber operator slowly, over another 15 or 20 minutes, brings the unit back to the normal atmospheric pressure. Usually multiple treatment sessions are required, sometimes up to 30 for conditions like bone infections or laminitis. It is useful in treating chronic laminitis, and they usually see hoof wall growth after 20 to 30 treatments, and also wounds and blood-deprived tissue. It aids in recovery from carbon monoxide poisoning and smoke inhalation, as well as gastric ulcers, colitis, and intestinal diseases, skin, muscle, tendinous, and ligament issues, birth asphyxia, and dummy foal syndrome. And just for maintaining a general health maintenance program, such as shorter recovery times and race courses. As far as its effectiveness, to assess any new treatment, it's necessary to objectively evaluate the treatment's effectiveness by examining parameters of healing, specifically for hyperbaric oxygen therapy. This involves whether or not it elevates the amount of oxygen dissolved in the blood, whether it increases the amount of oxygen in injured tissue, which is sometimes difficult to measure, and whether it improves ultimate outcome of disease or injury after being treated. And there is interplay between the effects of carbon dioxide on blood flows and oxygen, and it's unclear whether the same balance of these effects is achieved in all tissue beds. Researchers might see different treatment results depending on the tissue, disease, and treated animal species. And there are some risks associated with this. 45% of human patients showed signs of eustachian tube dysfunction during treatment. The most serious potential side effect is oxygen poisoning. Causes most serious damage to the lungs and the nervous system, and it can take a while for the effects to become noticeable. And also, in February 2012, an oxygen chamber exploded at a Kesmark facility in Florida. A horse kicked the chamber wall, which damaged the protective layer, and its shoe collided with metal, which caused a spark.
Oh my gosh.
And the explosion actually killed both the horse and the chamber operator.
Oh, that's a freak accident, isn't it?
Paul, yes. And so.
Okay. Now, go back to one of those chambers, because I just, like with that horse there, I can imagine some horses will not want to go in there. I mean, you know what I mean?
Right, I would imagine it's like for the other ones.
Yeah. Because, you know, that looks like an enclosed area, and it's like,
sometimes it's hard to move a horse around.